Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today we'll see a QGIS tutorial, which is about 2D animation in QGIS. So QGIS allows us for 2D and 3D animation. 2D animation involves creating a dynamic visualization of spatial data over a certain period of time. This can be particularly useful for showing changes in geographic phenomena like weather patterns or population growth, or for the spread of events like wildfires or disease outbreak, or the different kinds of accidents. So while using this 2D animation for dynamic visualization, first of all we need to have the temporal information or time data. As we know, time is a component of many spatial data sets, along with the geographic or location information. Time provides another dimension, which is the fourth dimension, you can say that, for the spatial analysis and for spatial data visualization. So if you are working with data sets that contains time steps or stamps, or if you have observation recorded at multiple time steps, you can easily visualize these data using the temporal controller tool in QGIS. So in this tutorial we are going to use 2D animation in QGIS for dynamic data visualization. So here we are going to use the maritime piracy incident data I downloaded from the website of the maritime data set. So here we are going to use the piracy incident data collected in different time periods, and we are going to use the 2D animation for visualization of this point data layer. So once we have obtained your data, you need to add the data here. So here I have this maritime piracy accident data with the land layer. So as you can see, I have the point data which shows the location of different piracy accident data. So first of all, we will create a heat map visualization or using the symbology or rendering one of the special types of spatial data rendering in QGIS, which is heat map visualization. And then we will use animation or 2D animation to animate the heat map to show how the piracy hotspots have changed over the past 2 decades. The data is collected from 2000 to 2018, so we are going to visualize the pattern of this piracy data using the 2D animation in this QGIS software. So as you can see from this point data layer, there are thousands of piracy accidents, and it is difficult to determine the place where this piracy incident is occurred more. So we need special kinds of visualization to better understand the pattern of this piracy incident data. So here this is my input layer, which is SMA event that shows the location of this piracy incident data over 2 decades, from 2000 to 2018. You can check you can download the data from the maritime piracy data set online. So to render the image or to display the image in 2D animation, first we need to create the heat map using the symbology or the rendering type. So just select the layer and use this, then choose this open layer styling panel here. So this layer styling panel will open here. Then next we are going to use the heat map rendering. Just click this symbology or single symbology and select the heat map option here. So you can change the color ramp here to display in a better visualization, and we are going to use a verdis color ramp. You can select the color of your choice, and I'm going to use this color ramp here. So next we can adjust the radius of this heat map, and also we can check or we can adjust the opacity or the circumference of the layer. So for the radius we can use 5 millimeters, and then we can change the opacity to 75%. You can minimize or maximize based on your interest. So this will give a nice visualization effect of the hot spots on the land layer below the this input layer. So here we have displayed the image in heat map. So using this color ramp and the heat map rendering symbology in this QGIS. So now let us animate this data to show the yearly map of the piracy accident. As I said, the data is collected for 2 decades, from 2000 to 2018, showing different amount or different numbers of piracy accident in different location. So then right click on this input layer and check the property of this layer. Then we are going to use the temporal setting option. From this option, just click this temporal, and then we take this or check this dynamic temporal control here. So for the configuration, we can add, we can use a single field with date time. So if you check the attribute of this input data, we have an attribute which called as the date of occurrence. So select this one. This source data contains this attribute, which is date of occurrence, representing the date of the date on which the incidents or the piracy incidents took place. So this is the field that we are going to use to determine the points that are rendered from each time period. So specify this input, then click OK. So as you can see, clock symbol will appear next to this input layer here. As you can see, temporal layer, we have specified the temporal setting here. So then just click on the temporal control panel from this. As you can see, we have the temporal navigation option here. So just click on this play option, and this temporal control panel will display. So by default, the date range is set to the current date, which is 2024. Just we are going to specify from for the initial data collection period, which is 2000 to 2018. So just click this set to full range to specify the starting of the data collection period. So automatically the animation range from 2000 to 2018 that are collected between the two years. So we have specified the starting and the ending period. Then we can set the steps to the year from this house. We can use the yearly. Then we can play the animation to observe the changes in this piracy accident location. So the animation will start playing, and it shows the location of this piracy accident over the globe. As you can see, you can pause and play and observe the locations of this piracy using this 2D animation. So now it will be useful to add a labels to the animation showing the dates of the animation frame being displayed. We can just add the year or the time period for each this animation playing or being played. So we can use the title decoration tool in QGIS to place the labels or the date of this animation. Just go to this view option here and then select the decoration option here. From this, select the title label decoration and enable this title legend, and we are going to use the expression to display the year of this animation for each scenes. Just write this code in this expression panel to display the year. And we can change the color of and the font of the label or the title. Just use one of the common types of the fonts, and you can change the size of the text. And we can also select the placement or the location of the title. We are going to place it on the top center here. Just click OK. And then you can display the animation here. Okay, let me change the color. Background color. So as you can see, we have changed the color, and the time will display for each animation. Yeah, so this is how we can apply the 2D animation in QGIS for dynamic data visualization. So if you have any comment in the question, you can ask me on the comment section of the video, and don't forget to subscribe and share my channel, and see you in the next tutorial.